Hello, in this video we will see clearance in first order versus zero order kinetic. First we will quickly see what's clearance. Then we will see clearance in first order and zero order kinetic. But before that I want to clarify one thing. All the processes or examples that we will be seeing in the video is for unit time. I won't repeat this word every time so that we can focus on what we actually want to understand and not get distracted by this word unit time. With that in mind, let's begin with clearance. We know that it's volume of plasma from which drug is completely removed. Here this much drug is eliminated. In the beginning, it was occupying this much volume in the plasma. So clearance is this much. Now let's understand clearance in first order and zero order elimination kinetic. First let's see first order kinetic. In first order kinetic, elimination mechanism is not saturated. So rate of elimination is directly proportional to plasma concentration. Means the higher the concentration, the more the drug is eliminated. To understand its impact on clearance, let's take three different concentrations and find out clearance for each one. This one has lowest concentration. This is in between and this has the highest concentration. Let's see the clearance for this one. Here the plasma concentration is low. So rate of elimination would be low and amount of drug eliminated would be less. You find out how much plasma is cleared due to this elimination and you get this volume. So this is the clearance in this situation. Now let's see this one. Here concentration is higher. So the amount of drug eliminated would also be more. When you find out how much plasma is cleared due to this elimination, you get this volume. This volume is same as this one. The reason is plasma concentration is high in this example. So although the amount of drug eliminated is more, it was occupying same volume in plasma. So the clearance remains the same. This happens over all the concentrations in first order kinetic. Let's see one last example. Here the concentration is highest. So rate of elimination would be highest and amount of drug eliminated would also be highest. But when you find out how much plasma is cleared after this removal, you get the same volume. Thus, clearance remains constant in first order elimination kinetic. Now let's understand clearance in zero order kinetic. In zero order kinetic, elimination process is saturated and rate of elimination is fixed at its highest point. For example, here this much is the maximum amount of drug that is being eliminated. Now this amount remains the same even when concentration of drug increases. To understand its impact on clearance, let's again take those three concentrations. See, this time it's zero order kinetic, where rate of elimination is fixed. So amount of drug eliminated in all three instances is same. Now let's find out clearance. First, this one with lowest concentration. Here eliminated drug was initially occupying this much volume in plasma. So this much is the clearance here. Now let's come to this one. Here concentration is higher. So the same amount of drug was occupying less volume in plasma. So the clearance is less. You see, the clearance is not the same for both the examples. Let's see the last example. Here the concentration is highest. Means even smaller volume was cleared after the elimination. So the clearance is lowest. This clearance changes with concentration in zero order kinetic, or in other words, it's not constant. Let's summarize everything. Clearance is volume of plasma completely cleared of drug. In first order kinetic, as concentration increases, the amount of drug eliminated also increases. As a result, volume of plasma cleared remains the same. Thus clearance remains constant. In zero order kinetic, amount of drug eliminated is fixed for all the concentrations. So at lower concentrations, more plasma is cleared. And as concentration increases, less and less plasma is cleared. Thus clearance is not constant in zero order kinetic. That's it for this video. If you found this video helpful, please share it with your friends and colleagues too. And don't forget to subscribe Nonstop Neuron, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.